Good evening and welcome to this evening's Equity Market Wrap. My name is Lisa Pallavi Barbara. It was a good day for the markets as both benchmark indices rose around 1.2% today, and it had to be since the results season got kicked off with Infosys declaring a better than expected set of numbers. The Sensex finally finished at 20,528 and the Nifty closed at 6096. Today's gain meant that for the week the Sensex finished with gains of around 3%. In fact, in this week, the IT stocks were quite strong and they were one of the big gainers, and also real estate stocks were quite strong and they were also one of the big gainers. Through the week, the weakness really came in from metal stocks and consumer durable stocks. If you look at what happened today, the BSE IT index was the biggest gainer, up around 3.1%, and banking stocks were also strong, and that index was up around 3%. At the bottom of the pile, metal stocks continued to be weak and the BSE metals index was down around 1.5%. Coming back to real estate stocks, market regulator SEBI has actually issued consultative guidelines on the operation of real estate investment trusts, and that rubbed off on realty stocks. So DLF, which had been rallying throughout the week, gained another 3.2% today. Unitech was up sharply around 8% today, and Indiabulls Realty was also up around 1.5%. Coming back to the stock in news today, which was Infosys, it beat expectations on its numbers and its guidance, and now experts are saying that they expect the valuation gap between TCS and Infosys to narrow. Today the stock ended with gains of around 4.8%. Another stock in news was Ranbaxy. That was in news because it has received a US FDA clearance for one of its plants. Although the stock did start the day with a big rise, it paired gains and finally finished around 1.5% higher. Coming back to the Sensex names, ICICI Bank was the biggest gainer, up around 5%. And other than Infosys, L&T was also up around 4.2%, and Tata Motors was up around 3.6%. At the bottom of the pile, it was Coal India, down nearly 4%, and also Tata Power, which continued to fall and down another 2.5% today. That's all from me. Do log on to livemint.com for more details. Thank you.